heat death of the universe is imminent. We cannot fight it. Instead, lull it to sleep with gentle kisses and encouragements. Press your fingers into the unknown and spread them in supplication, in wanting, I want to sleep, give us 5 more minutes, please. This is a shout out to all the kindred soft-spoken whisperers who pull sunshine from their veins like silk ribbons and shower our flowering peers. Your hearts are connected to the infinite void, and it's tenuous, it's strange. Where is the sunlight coming from? What does it burn? And when will the night begin? I swear, my smile is a kindness in more ways than you know, because it shows you my teeth, but it keeps my jaw closed. I am muzzled by the joy I find within and without me. I've got a hollow in my stomach that's overflowing. If I bit holes in your skin, in your leaves and your petals, in your peach fuzz and your lemon rind and peel, would the night begin? Are there silkworms in your bloodstream, and are they quick? Do you know how to burn the midnight oil, though nobody knows from whence it came or who slips through to refill it?
Yes.
Silkworms are only worms for 20 to 30 days. The heat death of the universe is thirsty, wants a glass of water, so slip down the hallway to the kitchen past slick sebaceous walls. There are clocks in your silent ice tray shaped like the 31 days of March and sunshine through your pulsating windows. When will the night begin? Why does the air feel like gelatin? We cannot fight imminence. Turn a blind eye and submerge your body in jello shots in a kiddie pool on your lawn alone. How are you affording all this? We do not know. But we know of thirst, and we know of wanting, and we know deep in our stomachs the taste of the unknown. Basically, when I'm sexually frustrated, I spout off poetry about the end of existence and mysterious natural resources. A questionable origin is I'm melodramatic as fuck. I mean, the end of the world is coming. Why aren't I?